Back in the side as well comes Eddie Gray for the first time since he fractured his ankle on December the 12th. The man who drops out of the side is Paul Madeley, but that's because he's sick. Bates takes the number 7 shirt and Nigel Davey is the substitute. And this is the lineup that their manager Don Revie says has not only got to win this match, but they've got to score goals in it to make their goal average better. And they're faced by the team with the worst defensive record in the First Division. 67 goals conceded, 44 of them away from home. West Bromwich Albion haven't won away from home since December 69, and in this match last season they were beaten by 5-1. So clearly we can expect the defensive setup of the Albion side today to be under some pressure. But perhaps it's worth recalling that of their 7 draws, they've drawn at Goodison, at Anfield and at Tottenham. And they still possess the top scorer in the First Division, Tony Brown, who's got 26 goals, and it could well be that Albion will keep that record at the Hawthorns, because last year, Jeff Astle was the top scorer in the First Division in league matches with 25 goals. The referee is Ray Tinkler, the two teams staying as they were in the kickabout, and it's West Bromwich Albion wearing yellow shirts and the dark shorts to get the game underway, a game that Leeds have got to win and in which they do need goals. And here's Eddie Gray with the ball. He scored within 2 minutes in this match last season. Clark is in the middle. Nobody behind, which is where Jones needs somebody. Now Bremner Square. That was almost a very good ball. Away by Lovett. Jones to Bates. The crowd already urging Leeds on. Gray, good try one. Cleanly taken. Hunter. Giles. Two to his left. Bremner forward. Clark dropping back to his right. Gray, Cooper, Clark. Good positioning by Clark. He was always a little bit behind the attack, but got no power in the header. Charlton. Greeny. Looking for Jones to Bates. Jones has gone to the near post. Clark is underneath this. Gray further back. Gray! It was a good cross. But Gray was there perhaps a little bit too soon. If he'd have come in with power, he might have got a stronger header. Hartford out here on the left, Kay the other way, this is Brown. Really ran into the path that Kay was going to take, offside against Clark. Alan Clark caught offside, what, 10 yards into the opposition half, and he didn't like it at all. Charlton underneath this with Suggett. Bremner. Bates, Hartford, into space, but nobody moving into space. Gray. 15 minutes of the match gone, no score. Clark trying to get round Kay, the linesman's flag up, and the free kick has been given in Leeds' favour. Charlton, just outside the box, number 5, 8 is Clark. Jones coming in, Coombs losing, Bates header, goal kick. Charlton up there, clearly as a decoy then, trying to create room for Mick Jones. Berrick. Charlton has just got back. Clark. Hunter. Cooper with Bates this way. Giles. Rooney on the touchline. Four players forward the other way. Bremner in a bit of space. Back again from Clark. It's a bit too tight, but only to Bates. Rooney trying to stretch the line of yellow, and they have done. Corner. Rooney well positioned to get round the back. Charlton coming to his usual position on the goal line. Leeds' first corner to be taken by Gray. It'll swing in. Bates obviously intended. Giles, Gray, Lovett, I've already seen that, but Saget sends Leeds away. Cooper, strong header out by John Kay. Bad one from Jack Charlton. Astle to Saget. Brown going like a train in the middle. This is Brown. And a goal. Tony Brown. Tony Brown, the scorer, his 27th in the league this season. But the goal, a direct result of a mistake by Jack Charlton.
And this team, why not, that their manager, Tom Reeby, says have not only got to win this match, but they've got to score goals in it to make their goal average better. And they're faced by the team with the worst defensive record in the First Division. 67 goals conceded, 44 of them away from home. West Bromwich Albion haven't won away from home since December 69, and in this match last season, they were beaten by 5 goals.
Break with no chance at all. He was sold by his defence, as one could see from the way he was shaking his head. They're using Rooney well. There's no left winger in the Albion side as such. Ford across it too. It's an awkward one on the near post, and Clark was there. Hartford with the clearance to Bates. Rooney still up, got back well, wasn't called offside. 5 to aim for. Clark, Giles, and Lyndon Hughes taking no chances, conceding a corner when the ball would have run for a free kick. And no doubt that there's now a greater urgency in the Leeds play. Jack Charlton up on the line there, number 5, marked again by Kay. Giles right footed to curl in. Jones just outside the 6-yard box, coming to him with John Wilde, didn't get that far. Punch by the goalkeeper. Cooper. Jack Charlton has stayed up. He and Jones coming now, and surely Charlton was knocked off the ball by John Wilde, and Ray Tinker, the referee, has given it. It's indirect for obstruction. No doubt that Wilde got in the way, and Jack Charlton must be pleased to find that he does occasionally win free kicks in the box. Fouls against him. And 10 yards back will take the ball practically to the goal line. That's the 6-yard line we're looking at. And it's what, 2 yards outside when they go back. They've got to go back an awful long way yet. And I don't think Mr. Tinker's going to find the job easy. Much, much further. They're only 4 yards, 5 yards at the most. A farcical situation, and one that Leeds aren't enjoying. Wilde again, he'll get his name taken in a minute, and rightly. You can understand their feelings, though, the Albion players. Gray! And inevitably blocked in a wall, which in the end was about 7.5 yards off the kick. Something has got to be done about this. Walls are never 10 yards when they're in that sort of situation. And Bremner didn't like that at all, and tempers are getting frayed. Giles with the free kick. Jones! Straight into the arms of Jimmy Coombs, but a good header. the ball for Rini. He didn't have much chance. It was a ball aimed at the bridge of his nose. Astle. 5 minutes of the half remaining. Albion still a goal up. That's an awkward cross. Away by Hunter. Offside for the umpteenth time. A problem that Leeds have got to solve in the second half. They've only got injury time to solve it in this half. Doesn't make for entertainment, but it's enough to stop the league leaders at the moment. For running to Hunter as Mr. Tinkler blows his whistle for the end of the first half, with a scoreline which will reverberate around Highbury. West Bromwich Albion leading by a goal to nothing. The goal scored by Brown from one of two attacks that Albion had in the half. And as the players go off, Don Revie, the Leeds manager, has got to give one of the best half-time talks of his managerial career. Jack Charlton, whose mistake divides the two teams at the moment, and John Kay, the man he came out with for the second half, whose organisation has done most to deny Leeds in the first half. And Leeds have got their substitute on, Nigel Davey, and Don Revie is gambling again. He's playing Terry Cooper as a left winger. Mick Bates has gone off. And there is no doubt the Leeds have got to move this ball much, much more quickly in midfield if they're to open up this Albion defence, which is relying fairly heavily on the offside trap and working it very well in that first half. Astle with no chance to take that. Hunter with the throw to Johns. Davey. This is Suggett. Brown in the middle. Jack Charlton stopping it, reaching there at all. Hunter. That's more like Hunter, who really had a disappointing first half. Jones. Giles. Cooper calling for it up front. This is Davey. Bremner. Gray. Eddie Gray's shot. Tremendous test this next 45 minutes of Leeds United's character. Hunter getting too far forward. Suggett being pushed a bit by Hunter. Brown, there's a chance for him. Stopped by Drake's leg and then pushed straight into his arm. For the second time in this match, Leeds were dead. But how many lives are they going to have with Tony Brown around? Something or somebody has got to take this Leeds side by the scruff of the neck and remind them of their pedigree. Cooper. Lovely dummy. Good header by Wilde. Great appeals for a penalty. But I think it was his head. Hope back to Coombs. Now been looking nothing like the side with the worst defensive record in the First Division. Suggett. Suggett and Brown. Hartford. Suggett and Brown are really making a meal out of nothing up front. Hunter. Bremner. And Bremner and Lovett really going at each other. Bremner really flew at Lovett then. The free kick must be against Lovett. Bremner retaliated very strongly. Quick words to Mr. Tinkler. No dramatics. Clark beat Kay that time, and Wilde covering at the back. In comes Gray. Lysman's playing off for offside against Jones. It won't count. It won't count. The linesman on the far side had his flag up before the header was played. Love it. Thought twice about a back pass. presents it to Bremner. Charlton going up. Davey, Charlton is up there for the cross. So's Jones. So's Clark. It's a good header and a great save. Fine header by Adam Clark and a truly remarkable save by Jimmy Coombs. Clark with a classic back header that almost crept in. The fires are beginning to burn under Leeds United. It's got to come, surely. Header out by Kay, he'll stop it if he can. Fine shot by Giles, but it's stuck. Saget, Charlton, Astle, Hartford. Giving it back to Charlton. Away comes Hunter. Cooper. Hunter going forward this time, Charlton staying back. There's Cocker getting out to collect the ball. Everybody on the lead staff helping as much as they can. Clark, Cooper on the touchline. Ball the other way. This is Hunter. No, but Ayerley. Only just over the top. Hunter. Brown, Saget, Astle steaming forward. This is Astle. Didn't run for him. Saget, Brown. Once again, the blood pressure goes up, and Gary Sprake giving his defence hell. Quite frankly, there have been times in this match when he hasn't had anything in front of him. Jones and Clark up. Clark under pressure from Weil. No penalty. Referee immediately waving play on. In fact, only the fans thought it was a penalty. Saget again with a bit of room, but nobody to help him. Brought down by Hunter. Quite blatantly. Referee going over to talk to Norman Hunter. Totally blatant. Bremner complaining. Hope with the free kick. Wiles header. Away by Bremner. Hope. Saget. But he was offside. They can breathe again. Hunter. Pass intercepted, but Saget is offside. The referee waving him on. Brown is going straight through, taking on Sprake. And the goal by Astle, and Leeds will go mad. And they've every right to go mad, because everybody stopped with the linesman's flag. Leeds have every justification for going mad, although one must add that they played to the linesman and not to the whistle. But you can understand the feelings of these Leeds players. Dunreavy on the pitch, the linesman going to talk to the referee. But when all is said and done, the goal is going to stand. But what a cruel goal. Listen to the crowd going mad. Meanwhile, the players still protest. There is no doubt that the linesman had his flag up. No doubt that Mr. Tinsel waved play on. But the vital fact is that there was a moment's hesitation by the referee which caught Leeds absolutely dry. And the linesman on the far side, Mr. Burbeck of Langley Park, County Durham, seems to have had something thrown at the back of his neck.
Attention, please.
It's a disgusting action, if that is true. Cooper going in, Weil again with the header. Hunter. Giles. Clark is there. Still there, Clark, and he scores! From an almost impossible angle, with the flick of his right foot. Adam Clark has scored with 2 minutes plus injury time remaining. And Leeds live in hope. This match or not. 1.5 minutes plus the time that the referee adds on for the hold-up after Albion's second goal, which we estimated about 5 minutes. Listen to the crowd now. Davy, Giles, and Leeds have got a new wind. Screaming, Giles! Cooper underneath it. Beaten by Hughes, comes to Hartford. Six up against two back. Hartford. Hunter for Leeds. Brought down by Hartford. And Brown wasting valuable seconds. Up all the time, it is Mick Jones! Just a touch then from John Wire was enough. Well, it was kept in play and wrongly. America's hurt. He's on his feet, diving into the chairs. Leeds have got the ball. Gray, Cooper. Charlton, beautifully taken by Coombs. And we're now playing the time that Mr. Tinkler is adding on for injury and stoppages. Wrestling match going on between Reaney and Brown. Free kick given to Leeds. Charlton. Clark and Jones forward. This is Jones. 3.5 minutes of time added now. Giles. Gray, Clark, Jones, a little bit of pushing by Kay, but play continues, referee calling it even. Hope, Greeny. Mr. Tinkler once more looks at his watch. Cooper's face. The free kick to be taken by Davy to Gray. Cooper! He just couldn't get a touch as he fell away to his right. And they're complaining that he was pushed there, at least Charlton is. Four and a half minutes of time already added. To pump it up the park again. Lies flag up for offside, and the referee's whistle for the end of the match. And Leeds beaten by a goal which will rankle for years. A goal in which the linesman gave an offside decision against Suggett. The referee allowed play to go on, but there is no doubt that Mr. Tinkler hesitated, and that is the vital point of the argument. Leeds beaten by 2-1, and their championship hopes in shatters.